So a director of the My Little Pony A New Generation movie was recently interviewed by some Latin America Brony groups, and several fascinating details came out of the discussion. I very much wanted to share some of these revelations as well as give my own take on a few of them. Sonny isn't an Alicorn in the friendship is magic sense in the movie. It's more of a magical effect. Nice to get confirmation that Sonny isn't going to be an Alicorn in the ways we might expect from the Friendship is Magic series. I think I would prefer to see her as an Earth Pony most of the time. They worked with Megan McCarthy and Stephen Davis due to their knowledge from Friendship is Magic, and he was very impressed with how much Megan knew about pretty much everything Pony. Glad to hear that the current MLP staff is taking notes from the previous MLP staff, as it certainly added authenticity to the world. The ponies didn't look good with cutie marks on both sides in 3D, so they decided to make them single-sided. In the end, this wasn't actually a Hasbro demand. Now, I've been seeing this question pop up endlessly since the movie was released, and it is helpful to know that this was more a design choice rather than a corporate one. There are two mountains during the end of Sonny and Izzy's duet song. One was going to be Canterlot-esque, but they decided against it to avoid creating an exact time skip between generations. I will admit, that would have been a nice Easter egg to see Canterlot in the distance, but given some of the other details revealed further down below, I can understand why they didn't go in that direction. They wanted G4 locations to be far in the past so they could completely reboot the world and start new. This includes the main six, who they didn't come up with a fate for. So many fans, myself included, have been speculating on what might have happened to the main six. Seeing as how that element hasn't been set in stone yet, I am hoping that future stories will touch on this part of Equestria's past someday. And maybe the MLP staff will take a little inspiration from the Brony fandom in this respect. Hoof feathers were indeed removed due to collision issues. The story took about 2 years to work on. They went with regular animals instead of the magical beasts we saw in Friendship is Magic to further solidify that magic was gone from the world. Well. This would help explain why much of the world seems so empty compared to the Friendship is Magic series. I wonder what other consequences the lack of magic will bring. Sonny's father is 100% confirmed to be dead. I did kind of want to see Argyle still alive and well somewhere in the world, but ah well. I can still look forward to seeing Sonny following in her father's example. They didn't run off of a concrete reason for the three pony races originally splitting, but it could be explored in the series, of which director Jose is not a part of. Once again, this is a question that many fans had asked, and once again, I do hope this will be explored in the follow-up series someday. Hasbro introduced the original personality concepts of the characters they had in mind, and the team ran with them. Ponies don't use their mouths in G5 because they thought it was kind of gross, so they just used their hooves instead. I will admit, it was kind of cute how the G4 characters would interact with the world through their mouths, but yeah, I can see how that might come across very differently in a 3D environment. The movie didn't have a political agenda, but it did hint at real-life things going on. They included technology to relate better to modern society. They had 5 characters instead of 6 due to the limited amount of minutes they had within the runtime of the movie. They did use Brony websites to follow feedback on MLP as a whole. Given this day and age, it is good to see more studios take note of their audience reactions on a more regular basis. And again, maybe they'll pick up a few ideas on what to do with these characters and the world further down the road. All in all, though, some interesting tidbits of information. Finally got some clarity on some of the more pertinent questions amongst the fandom, and a few intriguing revelations which does make me more curious to see the follow-up Netflix series. But what do each of you think? From all these elements that have been revealed, which one surprised you most? And Do you agree with the directions made by the MLP staff in each of these decisions? Leave your thoughts in the comments below, because as always, I am Dr. Wolf, and I look forward to hearing from you.